Farming equipment has changed dramatically since the Industrial Revolution. Back in that time, you know, over 90% of the population was actively involved in farming, but that was primarily for the purpose of just having enough food to feed your family and to survive. Nowadays, farmers feed hundreds of people on what they produce. 100 years ago, on a farm, the primary source of power was from animals, from mules or horses, things like that. A lot of your acres had to be in hay just to feed the animals. With the internal combustion engine, it allowed a farmer to do a whole lot more with his acres than he could before. You put diesel in it and you can now farm those acres to produce food for human consumption. The tractor is very important, not just for peanut farming, but all agriculture. It's the main power source that pulls implements through the field.
The future of robotics and automation in peanut market is already started. We have already started to see some of the semi-autonomous vehicles like UAVs or some robotics, whether autonomous tractors or harvesters, into peanut production.
Autonomous means without intervention. So if I turn it on and I've given it a plan, it should operate by itself. So the main thing, you know, that technology is being used for is primarily to, you know, increase production and increase efficiency. In the 1980s, we started kind of a precision ag revolution. Basically, the GPS satellites allowed us to be able to map fields, and that has really improved the production from an equipment standpoint.
Over the last decade, the whole precision ag concept has changed tremendously with introduction of a lot of different technologies, and the word precision has almost changed where we're getting more and more precise every day.
Digital science and computer technology plays an increasing role in peanut farming. Essentially, the tractor has a GPS system on it, and it's talking to the satellites. The satellites in space are generally 3 to 4 foot off from a position. And so we use RTK base stations, that's real-time kinetic GPS signal, that correct that signal. So the satellites talk to our RTK base station that knows exactly its correct latitude and longitude points. And from there, it sends out a corrected signal to the tractor so that it can know exactly where it's supposed to be within an inch. Because if we're to the left or to the right a couple inches, those are peanuts that we're leaving in the ground and yield that we're not capturing. Now, as our population has increased year to year, we're having to feed the same or more people with less land each year. And with that, we're having to make sure that our yields on those planted acres are better each year.
Planters are very important tools for all farmers. A planter takes a hopper of seeds and it singulates seeds one at a time and it plants them in the drill or in the row. For that plant to reach its optimal yield potential and grow the most that it can, those seeds need to be spaced accurately in the drill or in the row. They don't need to be too close together or too far apart. In peanut farming, it's very important to have a very good method of harvesting the crop. You've spent all the year trying to make sure you planted the crop very well, you've watered it, you've took care of it, you've made sure that it doesn't have disease and pests and things like that. And at harvest time, you want to make sure that you collect every single kernel of those peanuts that you can. So it's important to have a good peanut harvester. When farmers came to us to harvest more acres within a day, we designed the industry's first unload-on-the-go peanut combine, which prior to that, you have a stationary tank on top of the combine, and once the peanuts fill that up, then you have to stop the machine and go and empty that into a wagon or a trailer. Well, with the unload-on-the-go conveyor, you don't have to stop. The peanut harvester can continue to harvest while the crop is being unloaded. Farmers can save money in a variety of ways from equipment standpoint. If they can harvest more acres in a day with the same amount of fuel and manpower, then it's more efficient for them. In the United States, agriculture as a whole has tremendously improved over the past 40 or 50 years. Not just in mechanization, but in the seed genetics and actually having a good quality seed that can grow and produce a large yield. So having all of the different agricultural research areas work together is important to the farmer to make sure that he grows the best quality crop that he can and make the most money for it.
Peanut breeding is very important to agriculture, particularly in Georgia, since Georgia does produce about 50% of the U.S. peanuts. And the growers, of course, wants to maximize their yield with reducing their inputs and their costs for producing that crop. And so therefore, peanut breeding is targeted towards achieving that goal. Peanut breeding is basically taking a mommy and a daddy and hybridizing the two or crossing the two and looking at the offspring to see if there's a better offspring than either mommy or daddy. A better offspring would be one that, say, has higher yield or has higher disease resistance, or it could have improved nutrition or other quality traits in the seed. So there are a lot of traits that we try to improve in peanut. The advances in computer science and technology that have impacted our work are many. As far as computers are concerned, again, their power has improved exponentially from a decade ago, and therefore the amount of data that we can actually utilize to ask questions and try to address those questions is vastly increased. Technology as far as genetics has also advanced enormously, and so those genetic technologies include DNA sequencing. And in the DNA sequencing, we've recently, in an international collaboration, sequenced the peanut genome, which has really led to a lot of advances. And so there's going to be some much faster advances made in improving peanut.
Farming's changed drastically over the years, and it's going to change more and more. As we enhance our technology and the size of our equipment, it's just going to be more impactful and get faster paced.
Making growers more precise and actually leading to less waste and more yield per crop.
Increasing efficiency helps the bottom line, and that's kind of what the technology is being developed for.
A timeline gives you a sense of accomplishment in the past. It also lets you try to communicate that sense of continuous improvement to the upcoming generation, that we continue the same innovations going forward as we have in the past.